Hello viewers, welcome to this video lecture. In this video lecture, we are going to discuss advantages and disadvantages of traffic
signal.
So we start with advantages of traffic
signal.
So here is the first point. They can provide an orderly movement of traffic. So we will see this point with diagram. Suppose this is four legged intersections and there are some vehicle moving in the directions and another moving from south to north. Traffic sign help to provide an order to these vehicles to come inside this intersections and orderly can dispatch from the intersections. So this is the first use of traffic signs. If the traffic signs is not installed in this intersections, the order of vehicle will not be applicable and haphazardous conditions, or you can say the chaos condition, will occur inside this intersection. So this is the first advantage of traffic sign. The second point related to the geometric layout. If the traffic signs with proper geometric layout and control measures, like sign, geometric design is related to structural of road, signs, control measurements like signs plus marking. If we deploys our traffic signs with these two things, the traffic handling capacity of intersection will be increased. The third point says that they can reduce the frequency of certain type of accident, especially right angled type and pedestrian accidents. So these are the two terms. In this case, if the traffic signs is applied, so the vehicle 1 and here the vehicle 2 will not be collide like this. So this type of accident is right angled accident. Fourth point says, under favorable conditions, they can be coordinated to provide for continuous or nearly continuous movement. So this terms you might be note down, continuous or nearly continuous, but this can be achieved only a certain speed. You cannot achieve the continuous flow over the traffic over the intersections with a high speed as well as with a low speed. So you have a optimum speed inside intersections so that you can achieve nearly continuous traffic movement, and this speed is depend upon the size of intersection as well as the number of vehicles moving inside the intersections, or you can say that simply that is a flow which is incoming inside the intersections. The fifth point, they can be used to interrupt heavy traffic at interval to permit other traffic vehicle or pedestrian to cross. So with the help of traffic signs, you can cross the major road without accidentally, or you can safely cross if you are pedestrian for the particular case. In simple word, Suppose this is your major road and another one is minor road. So it is difficult for minor user, either they are driver or they are pedestrian, to cross this major road, because in this case the right of way is provided to major road. So if we install the traffic signals, so the traffic signals give the equal opportunity to minor road users. So this is the explanation of point fifth. Sixth point says that traffic signals dispense with police control and can thus be economically in simply means traffic signal can replace the police control or the manpower which is deployed by the police department or traffic police department. So traffic signs replace a manual procedure, hence they are more economical in case of traffic police department, because a person who work in traffic police having certain allowances, health issues, time dependent, as well as efficiency. So this is also related to traffic signs. The seventh one is, if properly designed and sets, please note down, we will discuss this design of traffic signals in later on, they can assign right of way impartially to traffic, unlike manual controls which can stop and interrupt traffic stream at personal whim of the traffic control. This point says that if traffic signal is installed for this intersection, the traffic signal are unbiased, okay, and they can provide equal opportunity to major as well as minor user as compared to the manual controller, which is little bit be biased and give extra green time for this major road users. Now we will go with the disadvantages of traffic signs. Yes, traffic signs has some kind of disadvantages. So the first disadvantage is excess delay to vehicles may be caused, particularly during off-peak hours. So when we go with the designing portion of traffic signs, we see that traffic signs are majorly designed for peak hours. Okay, the peak hours refer to those hours which contain heavy flow. So there are two peak hours. One is morning peak hours and another one is evening peak hours. But after these peak hours, the remaining time will known as off peak hours, and the traffic inside this off peak hours is comparatively less. So the users which is facing intersections feel excessive delays. So this is the disadvantage. This is only in case of fixed time signals. Okay, so please note this point. This is only in case of fixed time signal, and this case this can be removed if we apply flexibles, which is according which green time change according to the real flowing on the major and minor routes. The second disadvantage is unwanted signal installation trend to encourage the disobedience of signal indications. Means if you're providing a signal and without providing any warning related to the signal, the user will encourage to disobey the signal method, signal procedure, or the purpose of signal is not fulfilled. So you cannot install those signals which is not according to the laws. So this is the second point. Third point is, drivers may be induced to use less adequate and less safe routes to avoid delays at signal. So this point means, if there are two routes, okay, so this is our north point and this is our south point. From south to north, there is a first route. This is the route number one, in which there are multiple intersections occurs, and due to these intersections, signals are installed, and these signals providing some kind of delays. The route number one has delays due to signal. Okay, so this is only due to signal. I'm not considering other delays. I'm just considering only signal delays, which is fixed type of delays. And there are another route like this one. This is the route number two. Okay, so sometime the user use this route number two to avoid this signal delays. Even that, this route can cause less safer, or this route having more operation cost, but the user, because the number of signals can irritate the road users, so that it moves to this route number two. In this case, what will happen? Suppose there are n vehicles who are moving from south station to north station, but in route number one there are multiple signals, multiple intersections, due to which the driving from the route number one is not pleasant. So the more vehicles from this n number will shift toward the route number two, due to which they will face, the route number two will face more congestion as compared to the route number one. This congestion will increase the cost of operation. Okay, so this is the another aspect of traffic management. So we have to analyze these all things when we install our signals. The fourth disadvantage is accident frequency. It increases the accident, especially of the rear end type. Okay, when signal is installed, it reduces 90 degree accident. Okay, suppose this is a vehicle 2, this is vehicle 1 moving in forward direction, this is also moving in forward direction. At this point, if the signal is properly installed, so this will remove 90 degree collision. But due to sudden red light, due to occurrence of sudden red light, this vehicle 2 will stop or provide emergency brake. Behind this vehicle, there is a vehicle number 3 who is moving with a design speed, or you can say the approach speed, may be collide with this vehicle number 2, and this type of accident is known as rear end accident. So in this point number 4, basically the rear end type of accident will be increased. The point number 5 says, when the installation breakdown, because the signal is operate purely on electronic device, and if this electronics or this system of signal break due to certain reason, so there is a confusion inside the intersection, and it is difficult to sort out that particular situation. Okay, so that condition is very, very dangerous when the signal is failed or the signal is breakdown, because at that moment the 90 degree collision will also occur, as well as the rear end collisions will also occur. So this is the very important points that the system of signal must be continue work with 24/7, and there must be a routine check for that particular signal. So here are the figure of signals which we already covered. Like the first one is related to red light, the second one is amber, this is the red one, the second one is your amber, and the third one is related to your green. So this light contain, this signal contain three lenses. So this signal contain three lens, and the diameter of this lens is 300 mm. Okay, the signal is designed for 85 percentile approach speed. Let me clear this point to you. Suppose consider this is a intersection, a simple intersections. Okay, so I will draw a stop line like this for this one, and this one. So this is your stop line, and stop line means before moving this intersection you have to stop if there is a sign of give way and stop sign, as well as if the red light is shown in signals, so you have to stop before this stop line, which is painted on road with white color. So whenever you move on road, please watch these observations. Okay, so this vehicle which is at this location, suppose this location is L meter or L distance from the main intersection, so this will move with the high speed, or we can say this will be moved with operation speed. Okay, so operational speed or the design speed. Okay, so this design speed or operation speed, whenever it is moving, it may be, let's take the V meter per second. So this is the speed before the stop line. After the stop line, there is a intersection area. So you must be design your signal in such a way that this vehicle when cross this stop line and move in this direction, so the velocity must be 85% of small. So this is the, because this is the one parameter by which you will design your signal. So here is another diagram which is total cycle. What do you mean by the total cycle? Total cycle is the total time taken by a complete one cycle. Okay, complete one cycle means first your red light will occur, second your amber will occur, third your green light will occur, again there will be a amber light and then the red light. So this is the one complete cycle. The time taken to complete this one cycle is known as total cycle. Okay, and what do you mean by the phase? Phase is related to, suppose this is the intersection, so let me draw a signal. So there is a signal like this. This signal is indication for those vehicle which is moving in this direction. And here is another signal. This signal is give the information to those vehicle which is moving in this direction. Okay, so whenever there is a red light, this S1, similarly there is the red light on S2. So we can say that for road 1, whatever the color is shown in S1 will same shown to S2. So this cycle or the color shown on the signal is only for road 1. So this is called phase 1. Okay, the signal indication is only for road 1. Similarly, for road 2, this is your road 2, we have to provide signal S2 for this one traffic, and let's take this S3 and this S4, S4 for this one traffic. So again, the same concept can be applicable here. Whatever the position of light on S3 will be same on S4 because they are dealing with the traffic of road 2. So this means phase 2. So this is the phase diagram, and how we will study? You will study like this. The first phase gives the amber light and green time. Whenever there is a green time for road 1, automatically there was a red time for road 2. So we just draw amber, green, amber, and in this portion the vehicle of road 1 is moving, hence the vehicle on road 2 must be stop condition. So that's why we provide here red light. After red light we have amber, which is 2 seconds according to Indian practice, and after this amber light we have green time for road 2. Whenever a green time for road 2 is occur on signal, automatically red light will shown for those vehicle which is moving on road 1. So we provide here red time. So phase diagram, this is the phase diagram in which we decide our total cycle length as well as the length of green time. You can see easily in this phase diagram that this green time for road 1 is greater than green time for road 2. So you can also compare your green time for different approaches. From this phase diagram you can also conclude that road 1 has higher traffic volume as compared to road 2 because green time for road 1 or the phase 1 is higher. Okay, so this is the total meaning of this figure, and after the solution of designing of traffic signals numerical, you have to provide this total cycle time in the form of phase diagram. Okay, so this phase diagram is very important. Move to type of signal. We already covered that we have two types of signal, and there is another one. The first one is fixed time signal, in which the green period is predefined according to the flow of different roads, and this is fixed for peak hour as well as non-peak hours. Okay, so this type of signal is known as fixed time signal. The another one is which is work on the actual count of flow in different roads. Okay, so this will be like this. Assume this is a simple intersection. Okay, so there are some detector, automatic detector who count the number of flows inside the leg 1, leg 2, leg 3 and leg 4. According to these flow, they will provide the green time. Okay, they will provide the green time. Now there are another type which is semi vehicle actuated signal. In this case we deployed our detector only to minor road. Suppose this is your minor road, you can see this minor with width wise. So this is a minor road and this is a major one. Okay, so we provide detector to this minor road, because obviously the traffic flow in minor road is less as compared to major one, and the right of way is given to the major one, right of way given to the major one. So whenever there is a flow in minor one, they provide a small green time for minor roads. Okay, otherwise the fully green time or the major green time is provided to major roads. So this is the semi vehicle actuated signal. These are all our application in daily life. I'm not saying that this one is better than this one and this one. No, every type of signal is important. Let me explain how. Fixed time signal means if you have such type of intersections in which the importance of both the stretch or both the stretch convert into four legs. This is a four legs intersection. So these four legs having the same importance as well as the flow which is coming from these four legs is always constant or near to constant to whole days, then we provide our fixed time signal. Okay, but if the fluctuation of flow in this four legs are very high, then we provide our vehicle actuated signal. Okay, but vehicle actuated signal is provided only when the fluctuation occurs very high, but the importance of four legs are the same, means there is no minor major concept. Now move to the third one, which is semi vehicle actuated signal. It means you have two different types of roads which is intersecting. Okay, so by default you have to provide one major one and another road is minor. In that case you will provide semi vehicle actuated signal. So basically these three are important type of signal. Everyone has impact, only the uses will differ according to the condition of site. So this is the end of advantages and disadvantages of traffic signals. I hope you like this. We will meet in another video. Thank you. Have a nice day.